Oh, here's Nika's Rogad Garden Paradise. I'm giving you an update from last year, around like September, something like that. But it's now March 23rd, a couple of days after the first day of spring. And I want to show you the progress of the garden from when it had nothing. I had pulled everything out. All my summer crops, but these are my trees. Olive tree, lemon by seed. They say plant by seed, sometimes you don't get any fruit. But I learned growing the lemon tree progress planting by seed. You want to leave a lot of the leaves on. I used to cut and prune a lot of my leaves during the first day of the lemon. This is one of my lemon trees. That is a plum tree that I purchased from the store about 2 years ago. And this is a pear tree, and I do have a black berry tree. They are waking up, in other words. And this is a olive tree. I have sweet peas in here for the spring. They haven't come up yet because I'm giving you an update on my fall crop. And this is an apple tree. It's starting to wake up. Blueberry, peach, and this is my other one, the tree from seed. And I also have a fig tree that pretty much woke up. But they're waking up, and those are my herbs, which you will see later on in the season, because I just planted seeds in them. So this is my herb section. Well, we can come in the garden here. Of course, my little flowers, those are bulbs. These are my broccoli. I actually got to stand one of them up with a stick. It kind of fell over during the weather because it's been kind of raining and storming a little bit, you know, since the season started. These are my broccoli. Come in and check out some of the broccoli heads. You see some of them. You can come in, check them out. Look at the broccoli heads. Some of them are going flowering stage. I cut that off and make it do what it do. But these are my broccoli area here. I have some more broccoli over there. I just got some pruning, some of my mustard greens and my spinach, because we're going to eat that tonight. So look at my mustard green and spinach I pruned. So this is the area that we have. Of course, you can see I have some purple cabbage. These are collards. This is a cabbage. This is a collard. This whole row here is collards. This whole row is cabbage. This row here is broccoli. I had planted so many seeds, I didn't want to get rid of my seeds. And I have celery in the back here. I also have green beans planted, which they haven't came up yet. But the pots that you see that are empty, those are green beans. So I have green beans. This is a cabbage. This is a collard. This is a collard. So everybody look like they're doing pretty good for right now. I know I was trying to figure out if I started my crop early or late, which I think I started kind of late in the season, because when I actually came out here and put them in the ground, I put them in the ground around like November. So to me, I think I got a late start, but still a little progress, because you know, once it get kind of cold, it kind of slow down the progress of the growth. You want to have a lot of sun. So since it's spring, I'm pretty sure they're going to be like thriving. That is the method, which if you go to my other videos, you see my method, how I remove my soil. This is my cabbage and wheat area that we've been eating off of during the whole season, pretty much winter. So you can see I've been cutting on them, but these are my green Romanias. I'm going to come out here and repot some more lettuce crop. I'm starting the season inside. this is my iceberg area, which is only one here, then you know that. The other one here. And then we got red romania here. So we've been eating, and they've been pretty good. Tastes way better than the store brand. So we have like purple kale. I like the kale. I like the blue car kale and the kale. I don't know, I like the way it looks and it tastes good. And this is my dinosaur kale. The kale. Boom. Nice variety. I also have some red Russian kale. I like red Russian kale. I don't know too much about the look of red Russian kale. So I kind of like didn't want to do the red Russian kale this year. That's butter crunch, you know, lettuce. And that butter crunch I like really good. I really like butter crunch. It remains my favorites. And the kales. Those are my crops. This is my strawberry crop. I have plenty of strawberry, but they're blooming, so strawberry will be coming soon. And I have strawberry in the trees here. You gotta come out and clean up your leaves, people. You know, make sure you get the dead leaves off and stuff. And let the plant know you care about it, because they do know if you're attracted to it or not. It will attract itself to you to let you know to come clean me up. I'm looking kind of crazy. So keep your crops cleaned up. Maintenance your crops. Successful, you know, food processing throughout the whole season. Now let me go to flower. This is some Asian spinach, and it was very good. I have different varieties. This is like the spinach family. So you got the regular spinach here, Asian spinach there, which is flower. Then I have Swiss chard. You know, Swiss chard is in the spinach family and also the beet. So the leaves, you got the white and the red, and then you got spinach. I always kind of like space them out. This is my spinach area. We've been eating. We've really been eating. You can saute the spinach with some onions and some little, you know, mushrooms if you want to. Put a little cream cheese on there for some people who like that. But, you know, vegan, just eat the leaves, put a little, you know, side of pepper, vinegar or something. Eat your leaves. They're good. They're fresh. They're great. Especially if you're anemic or anything like that. You want to keep a lot of green crop and beets. Definitely beets for anemic people. Beets are good. So these are my turnips. I pulled several turnips this whole season because I overplanted them. So I repotted these turnips and they was like hanging over for like a week. I thought they were dead. But they all popped back up. They're doing good, but I ate plenty of turnips and I gave out some too, and they said that was great and was sweet. And these are the leftover turnips from the ones I put back in the soil. I got pulled them. These are carrots. I haven't pulled any carrots lately, but I will be pulling them. And these are the mustard greens here, and these are the purple mustard greens. Only did three, but you can look at pretty much how you, if you count the mustard greens, I had like 12 regular mustard greens, and that fed a house full of 8 people. And I'd say, did I overcrop? Nah, because we've been eating off mustard greens the whole season. I still have mustard greens, plus you see when I took off some leaves and put it in there because we eat some greens tonight. So these are my purple mustard greens. I like them. They taste really good. And one of the mustard greens is going to flower. And this purple right here. These are beets. They're not ready yet. But I did everything from seed. Everyone. I started all my seeds. For this, I I started inside, but for the beets, I started outside. The progress of doing beets outside in the ground is better. You can do them in the house or whatever, but I like doing them in the ground because then I had to come back out here and transplant. And for the record, transplant your plants. I learned using the Epsom salt water. It's better to water the soil with than just regular water because it helps keep the plant from going into a transplant shop. And that way your plant probably won't have to droop over for 3 or 4 days. But it comes back. So don't pull your plant because it's hanging over it. Just taking a moment to adjust to the area that you put it in. So don't think your plant is dead. It's not. It's strengthening itself. As long as your soil is fed, like I said, check out my videos. You'll know how to feed your soil. Feed the soil and it will feed you. So that's pretty much it for the garden right now. I just want to give you a recap of what's going on because I haven't been out here in a minute, like on YouTube, but I do have a job. But for those people who like to see videos on the regular, I probably won't be doing regular videoing because I'm working too. So when I have time to do my video, I like for people to see the growth of things. So I'm going to start doing some in-home videos for how I start my seeds and things like that. So that way you can get a lesson from starting your seeds too, you know, the Mika way. So everybody have their own way, but you can learn something. What I have known since the 6 years I've been gone. I'm about to go back in because it looks like it might want to rain again, which is a good thing. I started corn up on the side of the house early. I'm going to show you that in a couple more weeks. We're going to be out. And that will do it for the Mika's Grow Bag Garden Paradise. I hope you learned something. I hope you took my videos and actually seen the progress of things. How it grow, it takes a couple of months before plants get in a mature state. You start from seed, wait till the 5th week. That gonna take you about a good 3 to 4 weeks. That's real talk. So 3 to 4 weeks when you're dealing with like fall season crops, if you want them to be healthy. You don't want them falling all over and then put them outside. You want them to be standing straight up, strong. That's how you know what season is strong and what season is not strong. Make sure your seedlings are at a mature state before you bring them out here and put them in the ground. So, 5 leaves on them, standing up strong, mature state. Leaning over a little bit, it might not be too strong to handle the weather. But other than that, I appreciate you listening and looking at the video, and I hope you learned something because I always do. Thank you, Most High.